Hello, my name is Reagan Mastic, and I'll be your tour guide as we go through the missions of San Antone, where we will learn about the conflict and compromise they endured. The Alamo was the first mission of the chain of the San Antonio missions to be built in 1718. The Alamo served as a midpoint mission between the East Texas missions and Mexico. Today, it is the only church out of the five that is not an active parish. The Alamo was 118 years old when the Battle of the Alamo was fought in March 6, 1836. The Alamo will always be remembered for this conflict. Just 2 years after the Alamo was built, the San Jose Mission was built too, just 5 miles downstream. It is also known as the Queen of the Missions. The San Jose Mission gained a reputation as a major social and cultural center, and it also provided the strongest defense against Indian raids. The people that lived in the mission learned how to use firearms to protect themselves from the Comanche and Apache raids. The thick, strong walls also helped to deter these Indian attacks. Today's modern interior points people to God. Spanish designers and local Indians helped build this mission using Texas limestone and stucco. This convento had a flat roof that covered the 9 rooms downstairs and the 5 rooms upstairs. At the San Jose Mission, this window right behind me is pretty famous. It's called the Rose Window, probably after St. Rose. First established in East Texas, the San Juan Mission made its final home on the banks of the San Antone River in 1731. The native inhabitants suffered and died to the European diseases like smallpox and measles. When Spanish and native people came together, this created a new culture. San Juan still serves as a church for the community to worship like their ancestors did many centuries ago. Within a short amount of time, this mission became a regional supplier of wood, cloth, and iron. They also made things with leather by the Indians in the workshops. Behind me was a 10-year project, but however was not completed due to the lack of Indian workers. In the beginning of 1780, the remains of native people were interred in this church. The San Juan Mission's bell tower is still in use to this very day. Maintenance on these missions is required so that Texas history can live on. One of the most beautiful missions at the San Antonio Missions is Mission Concepcion. It looks almost like it did 200 years ago. Not visible today are the colorful designs that once covered this mission. The original paintings in the inside still exist. Some of the original paintings are religious symbols, while some of them are decorative. The mission was well known for its religious celebrations. It stands as the oldest unrestored church in America. The southernmost mission out of the five, Espada, was built the same year as Concepcion in 1731. Mission Espada is known for its unique stone archway. Many skills were needed to make a mission run successfully. One of them was blacksmithing. This is the blacksmithing shop at Espada. 1,033 people were baptized during the years of 1716 and 1773 here at the Mission Espada. As beautiful as these missions might seem today, in the 1770s, conflict arose when the Apache Indians started raiding their mission's ranches. The success of the mission depended on the success of the cattle and crops. Missions were primarily used for spiritual purposes, but they also provided protection from Indian raids. It took a lot of compromises to learn Spanish ways and live inside the walls of the Spanish mission. Yet, the missions experienced conflicts from inside and outside the walls as they made their place in Texas history.